You can never tell her.
So, have you ever smashed one client?
So about
have
this,
you ever smashed one
she'll
one
never
client.
Trust
so
about them cowboys.
Have you ever smashed one client? You can have never. You ever smashed one client?
You can never tell
I'll
her.
I plead the fifth, yo.
Hey, okay, so cheers I'm to that. By what I said earlier.
She's still thinking about it.
I mean, like, I gotta be like the pioneer to this shit, you know. I was popping that crystal when a lot of y'all niggas thought it was beer and shit, you know. Wearing that platinum shit when all y'all chicks thought it was silver and shit. I gotta really be the pioneer to this shit, man. Bottom line, I'ma show you how to do it. Check. Yo,
what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of Gems the Podcast. I'm Jordan Dantè with my co-host.
And I'm Mac.
Hey, man. Welcome back. Welcome back, man. We got our two special guests in. First episode of the season.
First episode.
Thank you. Yeah. So, you know, y'all are special, man. We had y'all. We appreciate
you. This is history. This is history right now. So, y'all should feel amazing.
I'm special. It's going to be
this is like the start of something. Amazing. So
we're real excited, man, to just bring this series and the segment to, you know, the world, man. We really want to give people knowledge and give them gems and, you know, have fun while we're doing it.
Man, so y'all introduce yourselves. Let's start right here.
Oh, well, I'm Amber. You can follow me on Instagram, everything by Amber DW Says. I have a podcast too.
Fire.
That says Shy's a frequent guest on there. That's how she's on here now because everybody loves her. So go ahead. That's all I do. Yeah.
So my name is Chy Fontanette. I also have a podcast. It's not out yet, but it's called Don't Be Chy.
Okay.
See the play on words?
I love it. Like that's fire. I like
that's
a branding. Like that. Branding and marketing is fire with that one.
So I have a podcast as well. It isn't out yet, but we'll look forward to that soon. Model, act, all that other stuff. So yeah, I'm happy to be here with one of my close friends.
Mm-hmm.
And this is family right here, man. Me and Amber, you know, we go way back,
mm-hmm.
train her wife. She's been to a couple of my classes before.
Fire.
Chy been to one of my classes.
And never came back. So
yeah, I remember. Why? It was hard. It was too hard.
That was like 2 years ago, I think.
Yeah.
Was it that long?
Was it
that long?
That was during COVID.
Was that G-Train?
Yeah. That was when
it
was
outside. Yeah, by the Popeyes.
Ooh.
That shit under a tent.
Yeah. It was hot as hell.
Under a tent, hot as hell. I remember, so I bartend too. And I remember seeing one of the girls, like I bartended one time at this event. It was a strip club. Not an event, like a strip club night. Mm. That bitch act like she didn't know who I was. I was like, you used to come to the bar begging me for shots. Now you want to be like you working out, getting your life together, and you can't say hey to me.
Oh, wow.
Oh, exactly. Damn.
I felt play about that.
Nah, you know how
folks say hey to nobody.
But Max class isn't for the week, though. You know what I'm saying? I haven't been back
not,
either.
No,
I haven't
not.
Been. So, you, yeah.
I've been there before. He's been there before.
Look, it's not for the week, though, but I got to thug it out, man.
But
I
men,
can't go outside.
If you want to meet you a good lady up in there, the ladies be in there. You know
I'm
what
dead.
I'm saying? I don't know why enough men don't go to them.
Strippers.
I be trying, man. Listen, we don't discriminate. We have, you know, every type of social person in there, you know, from strippers to lawyers to doctors.
You do be having
pastors.
You do be having them girls.
You look like you would fuck.
I just,
that's it. Ugly bitches can't go.
That's it. That's the one he got repost.
That boy will sell that class off.
I don't discriminate, man. But anyway, fuck all that, man. Let's get right into it, shit, right? All right,
go ahead, man.
So, ladies, I know you're married. You're in a relationship. You're in a relationship.
Yes.
So, the question is, how do you know when you're ready for a relationship?
Ooh, good
Let's
one.
Start
started
right
off
here.
Like that. Nah, let it flow, bro. Let him speak.
Let him
speak, man.
I've been married for a minute
Amber's
now.
Amber's extremely talkative, though, so you never know with her.
Shut the fuck
I know what actually she'll say. She say when she'll. This is what Amber will say when the pussy is so good.
Oh my god.
That's what she said. I know that's Amber. She'll say that. And she said, and then I've heard her wife has the best pussy from her. So that's what I'm saying. So I know that's how she.
Yeah, but I don't
but
like
you
to
think
go
she
and
biased?
Like. Tell everybody that because I don't want them try to come try the coochie.
I'm just kidding.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't try to tell people that my wife, it's the trashest coochie I've ever had, bro.
See, that's like, what I be saying.
Yeah, trashest coochie I've ever had. I just know she got my back. You know what I'm saying? Why the fuck would I tell the world? Yes,
she
fire
told my
coochie.
World that.
Nah,
oh.
Man,
yeah,
nah.
Y'all ain't
you gotta
special.
Pump, you gotta pump your girl up, man.
Hell
hell
nah,
nah.
It's a man podcast. You
no,
know what
oh,
me?
Facts. You right.
Nah,
don't man.
Tell everybody, man.
Why would I feed her to the wolves like that? Why would I feed her to
men? Love a good lesbian too. To see if they can like trade them out.
Yeah, how do y'all feel about questioning y'all?
What's
how y'all
up?
Feel? Y'all be trying to conquer down lesbians and shit? How y'all feel about that?
Well, first of all, y'all gonna answer the question. you're not gonna flip this.
No.
I know what they're doing.
They try to push it back with us.
Trust me, it's not gonna work.
Because Amber's feeling like.
So let's go ahead and answer this damn question. Okay.
Y'all homosexuals?
I don't feel like that. I'm still a woman.
Let's go ahead and answer this question.
And okay. I want to answer that question too after they answer, because I'm curious.
Yeah, so how do you know?
So how do I know? I knew when I didn't want to, that it was conducive to my life. Like in a sense of like, I didn't want to do the things that I was doing before. So I didn't want to like really go out without him. I didn't want to like, it just made more sense to me to be with my partner than with anybody else. And that's how I'm like, I have fun with you. Like it was also a friendship before it was a relationship. So it's like, it made it easier to be like coexist together because we were friends. And it also was like, everything I do, I want to do with you. Even though I believe in structure, you're supposed to have your girlfriend, your boyfriend, and everything, you know, in between. But, like, it just happened to where I wanted to do everything with him, and I didn't give a fuck what anybody said.
I feel that.
You know, that's crazy. So, I heard like friend. That. I heard
so
friend.
Yeah, I hear that, too. But do you think that it's important to be your friend first, then get in a relationship?
1,000%, because out of everything else.
No. All right, go ahead. I want to hear what you
out
say,
Shy. Out of everything
Shy,
else, like, at the end of the day, my biggest thing is a personality, to be personable, to be like, I need to have my homie with me. Like, if I'm in a tough situation, I don't want, you know, just my, I want somebody that we can laugh about the shit. We can have that type of, like, camaraderie where we just, like, you know what I'm saying? If I'm stuck in a bond, I don't want to be with just, like, I'm only boyfriend. I'm not about to make great, you know what I'm saying? I just feel like it's a difference of, like, I feel like a friendship is a basis first over everything else. And then sometimes it's hard for me when in a relationship because I give off that vibe. I'm so cool. I'm so chill. I'm so fun. That sounds really pick me. But like really, I do. Like I'm like, yeah, you know, I want to be your homie. I want to be a friend of yours. And it'd be like, sometimes it's hard to turn that switch off and be like, look, I ain't your fucking homeboy.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I be telling my man that sometimes I'm like, I'm not your fucking homie at the end of the day. So it's a line, but I do believe in a friendship.
I'm big on that too. Like the friendship, you know, even with my girl now, like we were friends first before, you know, we got in a relationship. Oh, and it just kind of, I'm just being honest, you know, it kind of just, it helps nurture the relationship.
Exactly.
And actually, if you want to grow it, you know what I'm saying? Otherwise, it's kind of like, yeah, we're trying to be fuck buddies and go on vacation and do shit you see.
Shout out to Cam, man. Shout out to Cam in the building.
Shout out
to
Cam.
But everybody's overlooking the friend shit. Like, that's why motherfuckers don't be trusting that platonic friendship shit now because, yeah, we was friends then. Next thing you know, the friends in relationship.
Friends mean that you don't rush into it. You getting to know someone and you can still be dating other
people. I rushed. And I'm still married till this day. Fuck.
So how do you?
I was gonna say. So
I'm a lesbian. That's what we do. What are you talking about?
Lesbian.
Nah, but I just didn't wanna. Like I lived my life. I've been partying since I was 15, and all that shit. I was in the military. Uh-huh. I just think she was the one. You know what I'm saying?
You.
So it's like, what else is out here? Then you know, you get older. You know, I got married at like 24, and that's pretty young. Thinking back on it, it's pretty young. But yeah, that's my partner. That's like, this is who I want to go through life with. You know what I'm saying? Like, yes, we have our bad days and shit, but still at the end, this is who I want to go through life with. But the friendship, yeah, she the homie and all, but like, y'all killing me with that friendship because y'all don't be as real with y'all partner as y'all friends. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, that's y'all friend, but to a certain extent, you're not going to be as real with your man as you are with your girls.
You can't say that for everybody's relationship.
Yeah, I mean...
You 1,000% can't say that for everybody.
Both of y'all be 100% real.
I mean, I don't have no reason to like finesse.
No, like
or,
how you
know,
really
you know,
but how you really feel like your girl be pissed. You gonna be more. You gonna tell your friends first, or one, not all your friends, but one who you vent to more than your girl. Like how you really feel. You gonna beat around the bush with your girl.
I think it depends on the situation.
Yeah, I was gonna say it depends on the situation
and then
for sure.
Also, I mean, in a friendship of like, be my friend first. Like if he was the first person I called when I had my hair thing. I was like, my hair. You know what I'm saying?
That's
the person I think about for everything, big or small, and that's what I feel like I want.
That's lit. That's what that is. Yeah, I feel it.
So now that you guys are, you know, tied down or whatever. Prior to that, like, what was it like dating before?
I was in a relationship before. I'm a relationship type person, you know. I don't.
So you was never single?
Yeah, but in the military, I was with somebody, and then like I got out of it. I was with him like for 2 years. This has been my longest relationship, but like
what was the time span?
From when you
were single to now.
All right, so I had got out the military, right, and I had moved out to Hollywood. Mm-hmm. And I was talking to this girl, and the girl I was talking to, she was like a straight woman before I got with her. So like I was like her real first lesbian relationship. So I had broke up with her. She had went to Florida, and I had broke up with her when she went out to Florida. And I ain't talked to her in like 4 months. And somebody had reached out and was like, you know, pregnant. Oh, shit, bleep her name out. Whatever.
I was surprised that you said that.
I was like, they were like, you know, be pregnant. And I'm like, what? I'm like, we only been together. I mean, separated 4 months. This motherfucker pregnant. And she was 4 months. Like, so she got pregnant as soon as we broke up.
Damn.
And like, I don't know, something about me, like, I was still fucking with her after the fact. And then like, I'm not proud of it. But
basically, she been a relationship person.
Yeah,
but like, Liv was at the crib. I had like finally got with Liv, and Liv was at the crib, and this bitch had drove 2.5 hours from Fort Irwin to come pop up on me at like 2 o'clock in the morning.
Damn, sheesh.
Pregnant. She was 6 months pregnant at the time. Like, she ran us off. Off the road. This bitch tried to kill us. She wrecked my car and all that, like trying to run us off the road. But yeah, me and Lil been together ever since. It was like trauma bonding.
Oh, yes.
That's a joke.
I was gonna say shit. I mean,
so
if y'all do some shit like that.
How do you feel about moving forward without being friends first?
That's crazy.
I don't care, but I got my friends. That's what I'm saying. Like, I'm not like that because I have my friends and I have a solid fucking group. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, me and Amber call each other and be like, I love, and we've started with each other. I started with her in a sense, but like, we do this thing where it's like, and it's just such a great bond to me. I love it. But like, we call each other, like, and it's so simple to be quick, and you got to be real with him no matter what. We'd be like, you started off with, all right, tell me if I'm tripping. And then from there, you really just cut out. You can't be fucking a yes man. You can't be shit. You got to just really lay shit out straight. And that's the people you need in your life.
Facts.
1,000%.
I agree. Just be solid. How about you, Shy? What was it like dating prior to your relationship?
Hold out. No, I'm just kidding.
I don't know.
Like an angel.
I think y'all need to operate in reality.
They say if it was like before 24 or something like that, that shit don't count.
No, man.
Before 24 don't count?
It counts.
That's honestly an issue.
You lined that one up perfectly, though. No cap.
That's the issue I kind of have in my, not now, but like in the beginning, I'm like, he never asked my body count. Never did anything like that. But I'm like, anything that I did before you just honestly shouldn't matter. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, you're technically not with that person anymore. I mean, you could be honest, but don't be too honest, I guess.
Men
I'd
hold
say.
That shit against you. Men hold honesty against you.
That's why I'm
it's
honest
too
mean
right now.
I'm pretty honest
you.
Though.
It's more so your past.
Yeah.
Because a lot of guys, like, let's be honest, a lot of guys don't want to wife up no hoes.
Of course not.
So, hoes get wifed up though.
Hoes get wiped up, but I feel like they do. But I feel like they go through that stage.
For how long though? Like,
look at Amber Rose.
I feel like they go through that stage though.
She's still wiped up,
and she is wiped up by the nigga with the tattoo
that was cheating on her and all that shit. Wiped up.
I mean, I hate to say it, but that
doesn't make the reality. You feel me?
I'm not saying we're not saying it's acceptable, but it just happens.
Do not give a fuck. They
do not care about body count.
They play about a whole different set of rules. We're not worried about that.
White men will have $100,000 crib with a whole nother shorty staying.
Black men now.
Hey, I mean, that's true.
We care about our ladies' past, and it's like, as a man, you don't want to feel embarrassed walking into a room knowing that 10 dudes done smashed a chick. You feel me?
That's the biggest thing
with men in general.
But how y'all feel if you walking in a room with your lady and you didn't smash 20 girls in here? How you think
that's
your lady feel?
Way more.
We're not the same.
I mean,
I know
still,
it's not the same, but how you think your lady feel? Like, damn, my nigga done been a has been. I think
but
it's,
how they, she probably how they think know. That, damn, he really popping.
No, are you? A, I was gonna I say how, like that. Like,
I don't think, honestly.
Go ahead.
I feel like, this is me personally, I feel like if you don't have women or you didn't have women, your girl not really gonna look at you like as attractive.
Right into the division.
No, women don't want no dude that ain't got no bitches. Like, that's just reality. Do you want? I should not mind. But
you're hilarious.
If your girl,
I'm straight. I'm gay.
But
dude, is that true?
If your dude didn't have no chicks before you, like, would you really like take?
You know
him
what's
serious?
Crazy? I remember one of his family members. We was all lit, and she was like, he done brought home some bad bitches before, but he was like, ain't none of them got a personality. And they were like, ain't none of them got a personality like you. And I was like,
hey, that's a compliment.
It is a compliment. That's a compliment. But I also was like,
you feel some type of way?
I was like, yeah, he, of course, this is the standard though. But I'm like, it's still not comparison to me.
Right.
You can't tell right now though, but.
I just feel like, yeah, man, like, dudes, they're real territorial when
and
it comes to that chick.
Because it's like, I don't want to see my man getting, if I were to ever even look at a DM or go through a phone or anything, it's nothing worse than seeing your man, like, shoot a shy miss in somebody's DM. Like, the lame ass. Girls don't even want you while you in the DM.
See? That's a difference, though. See? But yeah, that's
all right. So I want to ask y'all a question then. All right. So, I mean, us three in a relationship, Max single.
You single? As ready to as mingle?
Being in a relationship, what do you think about friends of the opposite sex?
I don't fuck with that at all.
Y'all go ahead and answer.
Y'all don't fuck with it because y'all done fucked y'all friends before and now y'all in a relationship with them.
Can I explain mine?
Yeah.
All right, so I'm cool with it to an extent. I tell her all the time. Mm-hmm. I'm cool with it to an extent. One, because I'm just a big networking relationship person. So I'm cool with meeting girls because, just to be honest, niggas is haters. Niggas don't put niggas on.
That's facts.
Just being, you sit in the club and you see niggas having chain wars and shit, or bottle wars. You know what I'm saying? Shit. Like, niggas don't ever put you on to game. They don't put you on business. Nothing. Girls, they do. Mm. So me personally, I'm cool with like a lot of females because I know females will put me in that position and I can also do the same.
And what position? And they,
be honest with you, it's more you in like a work type vibe. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Like, I got a homegirl that tried to put me on advice. You know what I'm saying? But I know a nigga would not do that shit for me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Especially even with my clothing brand. Mm-hmm. I see a lot of females that fuck with my clothing brand more than my niggas. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because they feel kind of envious. And I wish niggas weren't like that. But that's
is
just
that
kind of like.
Brand?
This is.
Shameless plug.
Shout out to Cozy.
Shout out to Cozy.
Oh, yeah. You was.
Yeah.
Shout out to Project Apparel. You the guy that he had the girls going crazy in the DMs.
Correct.
Okay, gotcha.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. They were going crazy on his comments.
Up. What happened?
The black
your comments when they was talking about you ain't we like black girls
up,
or something.
We ain't going to bring that
yeah,
up.
Yeah, that was. But yeah, that was my clothing line. Thank you. Appreciate it, man. Yeah. Definitely trying to roll it out and. Go viral. Yeah.
So can your homegirl? I mean, so can your girlfriend have friends of the opposite sex? Because you're talking about.
I don't mind. I personally don't mind it as long as it's not you're not overstepping your boundaries.
But does she? You said men will say they don't mind it, but does she? Does she really have friends like that?
I mean, maybe a hot few.
Nah,
but that's
I don't
it.
Trust it. I don't. It's
just I don't trust it.
I believe it because men will have that double standard to the fullest when it's beneficial to them. But if it ain't beneficial to them with their girl, then it's a problem.
I'm
my girl can have female
business.
Friends. I mean, yeah, male
that.
Friends.
That's
just
me. He told me that shit.
I'm sorry.
I'm just. I guess I'm
just
more of
me.
A.
I'm kind
of
on that. Like Amber, I think we kind of agree on the same thing.
My girl can't be friends with her exes. That's
yeah,
my thing.
Nah,
you
I
know,
get the
shit
exes.
Like that.
Well, that's already.
Nah, but it's.
But I feel like
that's a
given. That's a given. Yeah. Yeah, that's the word.
She can. It's, yeah, just more because I don't want to sound too controlling too. You know what
exactly.
I'm saying? Because it's not jail. You know what I'm saying? We got our own individual people, but yeah, it's just I know dudes would want to fuck on Liv. You know what I'm saying? Like you're the only dude that I don't know. I probably thought you tried to fuck on her once too. I'm be honest
he
with
said,
you.
Of course. Of course, dudes want to fuck on
yeah,
the course.
Yeah, so I'm like, I'm hesitant with all these niggas. You know what I'm saying? I'm hesitant with all these niggas.
I mean, I feel you.
Yeah, yeah.
He
so
can't
I
be
don't
like,
be.
Listen,
I'm
man.
But it's my girl at the end of the day that I got to worry. It's the niggas going to go. It's like, my issue is with her. She going to go. You feel me? That's all.
No, see, I disagree with that in a sense. It's too. I'm sorry that. If y'all
go ahead. No, go ahead.
Well, actually, we're the guests. So.
Exactly. Facts. Talk.
We want to hear your input.
So I get what she's saying, but when she says it's my girl, in a sense, I don't agree with that because I'm like, at the end of the did you mean it in a sense of like it's on her to deny and do that?
Yes,
it's
on
her.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah,
that's what I said, entertaining.
Dudes don't go if they move.
Okay,
that's all day.
That.
But it's
all
on her. She going to entertain that shit or not.
Exactly.
So my issue would be with her. Not them. Never issue with them.
I agree with that.
And I love how you kind of said, like, you know, you're your own person. Mm-hmm. At the end of the day, we come into the world by ourselves. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? We connecting in the same world when it can't be attached.
Yeah.
At the end of the day.
I just don't ever want it to feel like any relationship to feel like prison.
Nah,
you know
never.
What I'm
oh, yeah. And I don't think that I get what you're saying. But in the same sense, it's like.
But it
same,
can get like that.
It could get
it can.
Like that.
It can.
And the same level of respect that I give to you is what I feel like should be returned.
Oh,
so
1,000%.
It's like if I don't. Like, I just recently had a talk with Amber about like how my. I didn't want to go there, but...
No, let's talk about it.
Let's talk about it, please.
How I had an issue with liking pictures.
Mm.
And look, I don't give a fuck what nobody say. If I'm toxic on a level 1,000, I don't give a fuck. I don't like it. Mm-hmm. I don't like my man liking pictures. I think it's disrespectful. If that's a level of disrespect to me, stop it. Point blank, period. I have people that are like, it's not that deep, but I don't give a fuck. I don't care.
Is that why you put that post up?
Yeah, but not okay. Because her, but we had went and hit the streets already, and nobody agreed with her. But in the comments, everybody was agreeing with
because
her.
Because at the end of the day, I'm like, if
it was black women,
if it's a boundary,
all the white women was like, I don't care about that.
Yeah,
all the
also,
other non-racists, they didn't give a fuck.
Right.
But it goes deep in that. It's the principle for one, which we stand on, and it's if it's a boundary for me, you shouldn't cross it. Because if something is a boundary for you, like first step, for instance, you don't want me having male friends. Okay, cool. Before you, if I, the friends that I had then and that, you know, we obviously did nothing together. I had that type of reaction, interaction. Cool, I can still be friends with them. But if it's a boundary that you have, I'm not going to cross that.
Right.
So if I'm telling you I let it slide for like a year, I would see my man's name next to big booty bitches. Mm-hmm. And I got a slim one. You know what I'm saying? Right. So that made me feel bad. That on top of that made me feel a little
this
like,
what you really like?
This what you like, big booty bitches?
So question. So is it the type of picture?
No. What pissed me off even more was when they would be fully clothed and beautiful. So it doesn't matter. But I let it slide for a while. So I've addressed it more than once at that point. So it's like after the third point, it becomes disrespectful.
Right. So no solo pics, no selfies.
I guess
it's
like
nothing. If it's not your grandmother, Jesus Christ posted a selfie himself.
She's crazy.
Family members do not like it.
So what if it's her like helping out the homeless? Like
I don't care.
Yeah, why are you liking that picture?
I don't care.
That's my eyebrow there. Why is you liking this picture?
And then when you go on the person's girl's page and it's like back to back. Bro, the scroll is crazy. When you see just your man, 582. See your man, 582. Bro, it's disrespectful, and I do not care what no one says.
I feel like you
want to
have a peaceful day, though. If you want to have a peaceful day, you wouldn't go in looking for that
if
shit. You know what I'm saying?
You got to know your boundaries. I got to wish you said.
I went through all 2,800 of his followers. And
just
went,
to be mad.
Because I seen one on the Explore page, and from there, it was a rap.
Just to ruin your
day. It was a rap after that. So I'll go back to that. Like, I'm big on boundaries. So if you're respectful to that, then I get you on that.
Exactly.
But sometimes I'm kind of like that too. I mean, I do social media for a job, so I'm kind of like the shit's fake. It's minute. But what I had to learn is other people don't think of it like that.
They don't.
So you got to respect that if you want to be with somebody.
1,000%. If I'm seeing a man like my pictures a million times, I'm like, he wants some attention. Before I was in a relationship, I would go look at his page. If he's cute, you know what? Maybe I'll like a few back. That's literally what it is. That's there's no.
Are you a new follower? Let me get my likes in. How about that?
No,
man.
People go and like my shit. Gotta do that. Women can do that all the time. Men don't have to. You really don't.
One of my homegirl's cousins came and followed me, and I didn't even know he followed, but nigga had went in like 20 fucking photos.
Sometimes
you know
they do that to get attention, so you can follow them back. You're gaining attention.
Oh, got it. Because I did go follow him.
Exactly.
Yep.
That's what I'm talking about.
I didn't know that.
That's a lot.
Okay.
Look, for one, exactly.
Yeah, I mean, that's what my bot does. I ain't gonna lie.
So let's change gears here. So, like, in the relationship, right? Or just in general, like, what are some turn-ons and turn-offs that y'all have?
Shitting with the door open. You know what I'm saying? That's a big turn-off for
me. That's very nasty. I ain't gonna cap.
My wife will come sit on my lap while I'm shitting. Like, she love me, you know what I'm saying? But I can't stand to smell her shit.
Damn, that's some real love. I ain't no cap. Because I got to shut the door and lock that motherfucker.
I'll be on the toilet.
No cap.
I'll be on the toilet. She'll come sit on the floor and we'll be like smoking. I'm like, yeah, this is crazy. I wouldn't do that, though. I wouldn't.
What was that one shit when they were younger? They called that like, what was that one? It was nasty as fuck. Like Blumpkin or something. Blumpkin or some shit where like you would get some head while you was taking the shit.
Oh my goodness, that is disgusting.
Dog.
What's a turn off for me?
You know
what they call them now? Icks. They're like icks now. It's a thing. Like girls be going on, like it's like a TikTok trend and be like, what's an ick? And it'd be like the simplest shit. They said one ick was when a man drop his change and he run after it on the floor. Like just stupid stuff like that. Like little things be like ick. I like
that's
when he get
that's a quarter, I'm getting that. I don't know what you're talking about.
My man
coin
he
star
ran
that
after
bitch.
Them coins. Disgusting automatic turn off. Or like somebody said when a man walk with too much hips, automatic ick. Like just little
what's your
like
turn
that.
Off?
Yeah. Oh mine, I just thought it was hilarious. I just recently seen that. My turn offs. I'm so in love right now, so I really can't think of anything that'll turn me off of my relationship now, but like
it's nothing.
Probably
basic shit though.
Basic. I remember one guy I was talking to one time. He used to touch me like very softly like this.
I hate that shit.
And it would disgust me. And I feel like his hands like, were clammy. And I'd be like, get the fuck off me. You know what I'm saying?
Like an ant or some shit.
Like I don't know. If an alien had fingers, it would have been him. And I just hated it. So I don't know. That's a turn off for me. But also, if we want to get really like deep about it, what's a turn off is someone not taking accountability. Mm. Or if I'm always the one apologizing. And like, it's always my fault.
Facts.
Do y'all apologize?
I fucking will apologize till my head turns blue. I'm different with that because I be trying to keep the peace.
Keep the peace.
Keep the peace. I have never heard a female.
listen. I have never heard a female take accountability for anything.
Hey man, bro, I'm all for that, bro.
I'm big on accountability. So I can't do it.
I have never seen that. That's
I'm
crazy.
A solutions person. I don't need no issues.
I don't like to harbor feelings or emotions for long. So I'm like, what's the problem? Let's get over it. Let's move forward because I don't want to be mad, because that's not just my personality in general. Like, I don't want to be mad or aggressive all day. Or mad or some, it's usually 9 times out of 10 stupid shit.
I'm like that.
You know what I'm saying? She's an Aries. That's why.
I'm an Aries too.
So, oh my goodness. So
I mean, we're not confrontational, but we about that. You know what I'm saying?
Like, if you take us there, we really like that.
Yeah, and it's just, to me, I just be feeling like 9 times out of 10 arguments really aren't worth it. So I'm like, look, if I did something wrong, I apologize. Let's move forward. And the argument now that I get in my relationship is like, well, you ready to move on and I'm not yet. And I'm like, oh my God, here we go.
That's with any relationship though.
Huh? Really?
Yeah.
It is. And I can I'm still mad. On the opposite end before and be like, but I don't really be mad. I be pretending because I'm like, you was mad for a day, so I got to be mad. You
know my goodness.
Reciprocate the energy. Nah, no cap for
real. So let's...
I was going to ask...
Go ahead, brother.
So I know you say you don't really have any turnoffs now. Do you feel like you're still in, like, the honeymoon phase, or do you feel like you've moved on from that?
I feel like it's honestly gotten better to me because we, in the beginning, we were friends, and so we were transitioning into a relationship. So that kind of was a
like your honeymoon.
Disconnect in a sense.
Gotcha.
No, not even our honeymoon, but it was still a honeymoon. It was always a great phase, but it was disconnected. We were still trying to, like, you know, transition to be with each other, like, you know, copacetically. And I guess now it's just... we understand each other better and better every single day. So it gets easier and easier. And we understand. And now these arguments shouldn't last as long as they've been lasting. These simple problems shouldn't. So now it's honestly getting better.
Fire. Mm. Yeah. See, that's big. I'm big on that. After you leave the honeymoon stage, it's like, all right, cool. What's next? Like, are you trying to grow? What are we trying to do here? Or what are we doing?
How long have you been in a relationship?
We going on 2.5 years.
Oh, that's a good.
How long did the honeymoon stage last for y'all?
Shit. Be honest with you.
30 days.
Nah. It lasted for a while. Being 100 with you, it lasted for a while. Like when we started moving, when we like start living together and you know, you kind of, you really get,
crazy.
Yeah, you really get the real person. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Right. You see if you like that motherfucker, if you hate him, and if you hate him, you still got to live with him.
I knew shit was real for me when I survived through the pandemic with mine. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people broke up during that shit. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? But it's like, damn, we ain't argue as much or none of that. Like,
you did tell me that. I remember that.
That's because y'all was smoking all day.
We still argue during the fucking smoke session.
Were you high?
Like, it be dumb shit. Why the fuck is you pushing a blunt down like that? Like, it be dumb shit. I hate how she take, like, I tell her put it out, save for later. She's squishing it like it's a cigarette. That's
really
an argument right there.
You just gotta sit it down.
Yeah,
what the fuck?
Yeah,
she a real smoker. I like that. You feel me? People don't know about that.
Stop doing that shit. It's not no cigarette. But yeah, but that's how I knew that it was really solidified because we lasted through the pandemic. A lot of people did not last.
Yeah. And I know a lot of COVID babies that came out of that shit.
A whole lot of COVID babies.
And them COVID babies different. I'm like, they coming out walking. You know what I'm saying?
No, y'all want kids in the future?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just cost a lot of money. It's crunch time for me, really. You know, my wife is, you know, a year older than me. Mm. So she about to make the 33 Jesus year.
That is not crunch time.
It is. Let them tell it. It's crunch time, man. Do we really want to be 63 and my kid just turned 20?
That's very true, no.
You know what I'm saying?
I said 32.
I said
and some M's in the bank.
Kids are expensive, though.
And M's in the bank.
I think it costs like $30,000-$40,000 a year to raise a kid.
M's in the bank.
I think it's more than that.
It might be more than that.
I think
depending where you live at.
Well, child care alone.
In LA,
you know,
probably is going to be more.
Oh,
you somewhere else.
Man. They was in Louisiana paying like $700 a week. For one child, you know what I'm saying? Like, shit's ridiculous.
Shit, they said tuition out here for kids is like 50 bands. I'm like, nigga, that's college.
50 bands?
What tuition?
For like private, private schools.
Yeah, that'd be in public.
Well, a lot of them go to private schools out here, though, because public school too crazy.
Yep, shit, they'll be crazy in public school. Fuck out of here, we ain't got it like that.
Nah, I gotta run that bread up before I do that shit. It's very expensive.
Did you get into a pandemic relationship? I know we all talking about.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? We ain't talking to Mac. We're Mac.
It's about me. It's about me. It's not about me. We ain't got guests, huh?
You didn't get into anything during the pandemic?
Just some cheeks.
No relationships.
You didn't get into a panty?
Just some cheeks.
You don't aspire to be in a relationship? You just on grind mode right now?
I'm just on grind mode right now. I think for me, like...
love will hold you back.
it depends. No, listen. No, it actually depends. I feel like right now, it's like I'm not looking for anything. Like right now, I have no expectations for anything.
You're in grind mode.
27.
Okay.
So... I think for me, it just has to be the right place at the right time. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And it just has to make sense. Mm-hmm. You feel me? So, like, I'm not just going to jump at the first person that comes at me that's, you know, presenting something that's, you know, that I like or whatever the case mm-hmm. is, or we vibe mm-hmm. good, cool. But, like, it takes time for me. Like, I got to vet you for a long time before I make sure.
That's that friends connection.
I wouldn't say a long time, but I got to vet you. I got to vet you. You know what I'm saying? Like, you have to meet, like, certain criteria.
And what are those?
Yeah, I'm kidding.
I mean, we can be here forever. This ain't about me, goddamn it. It's about y'all.
I mean, we're in a relationship. It also is a little hard. Because for what you do for work, it's a lot for a woman to honestly take sometimes. It's a lot because I know you see these women at their worst when they're working out, but sometimes women don't care about that. Women don't, you know what I'm saying? So it's a lot to take in for someone to, your line of work for a woman sometimes to take in. You have to really have high security, I guess.
Clout. Yeah, I was literally going
to
say
if you're going to be with me, like you have to have a high level of security, basically.
But you can never tell them.
You can never tell your girl. Because there's always going to be a lot of girls around me.
Yeah, but you can never tell your girl that you were smashing on your clients sometimes.
Fact.
But you can never.
You can never tell them. Smash one client.
You can never tell them.
Have you ever smashed one client?
So about this.
Have you ever smashed one client?
You can never tell
her. I plead the fifth, yo.
Amen. Okay, so cheers to that.
She's still thinking about it.
Putting me back in my place. She'd be like, when we were talking about this, she'd be like, all right, can't do that. Because I know they low-key think of it. I don't know what it is.
Yeah.
It's
craziness.
Respect. Listen, man, I'm a man.
There's respect.
Like, when it comes down to it, I'm a man. Like, you know, shit happens.
Men use that excuse of being a man as, like, doing hoe shit.
It's true.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's not fair.
Yeah, men can be hoes, too.
Just because I'm a man.
Just like a girl going and get 30 dicks in her, you go and put your dick at 30 different bitches. Passing out that dick.
Yes, it is.
Bitches are nasty. I don't know if you know. You don't bash the women. Bitches be nasty. And you putting your dick in 30 different women.
Hey, it's not the same. Men and women are not the same.
Y'all are not built to be with multiple people.
I've been with, you know, my fair share.
At the same time.
I have, and I'm a virgin.
Yeah, nobody. Not so saying men. You sleeping with 30 bitches at one time. We saying over the course, it's the same. Like, just like men, I know, like, you get entered in. Women get entered in.
Right.
So it's like, don't no man want a woman. Shit, don't no woman want a woman that the men slutted out.
Right.
But women look at men the same way. Like, yeah, he get bitches, but... you a hoe.
You are community dick to everybody.
But some women find that attractive.
I've heard that.
A lot of girls have miles on them. Some men like that.
Everybody to fuck, but not to wife.
No, you never know. Some men love a good roast beef. He'll come and grab you.
Roast beef don't necessarily mean that it's been pounded down.
I'm just kidding.
No, I'm just saying because people don't be knowing
that. No, but most men, like, they don't take girls like that serious. They just,
girls that are hoes?
And I'm telling you,
just a good
I know
time.
A lot of niggas that
They're here for
hoes.
A good time, not a long time.
And there's some girls that look at you like, not you, but like munches. That's why I keep, that nigga
yo,
munch.
What does that mean?
Nigga come over, just eat this coochie.
What does that mean?
What does that mean?
Munching on some coochie. But it's girls that'll literally they'll sleep with you and tell a home girl, hey, yeah, he was good. Go fuck with that. You know what I'm saying? You don't want to be that nigga.
The girls
interesting.
Yes.
Sometimes,
interesting.
Because
I'm interesting. I thought girls are like real territorial.
No,
yeah, me too.
If you
like, you might not even like a dude, but she's like, no, I already been with him, so you can't touch me.
No, that's bitches that care. If bitches, you gotta get these bitches don't be caring out here. You know what I'm saying?
See, I don't know.
Hey, I never heard of that. I ain't gonna cap. I ain't gonna lie.
See, I tell you a joke.
Listen, man.
But I never tell you a lie.
Stay where y'all at. Y'all in happy relationships. Stay there.
Yeah, I know.
There ain't nothing out here in the streets.
Are you putting forth your best foot forward?
I'm not really, you know, putting no foot forward. Like I said,
I feel like everybody will always say that, but like, there's nothing in the streets. But I've really, honestly, felt like I've never really had an issue trying, like, getting in a commitment. And I'm like, of course, my man isn't from LA, but I guess LA could be a different vibe out here.
Are you saying you a hoe?
No, I'm saying I could be in a relationship if I wanted to.
You're attractive. Yeah, of course. Yes, you're attractive.
You know, I could easily be with someone, like, it depends on, like, what their relationship dynamic. I mean, I haven't really, but I'm just saying.
She basically saying, Mac, she wasn't in a relationship if she wanted you, nigga. She can get you. So all that motherfucking, I ain't looking for that. Out the window.
I mean, that remains to be seen. That remains to be seen.
Look, basically, on my end, I'd say you should just let it come to you. Yeah, that's what's not happening to me too.
Don't rush it, because relationships cost money, bro. Save your duckies, bro.
There's no rush out here. Plus, no rush. It's like LA, you know, like
you go out to eat, you got to buy for 2 hours.
It's crazy out here
in
LA dealing with these women. You know,
but sometimes your women keep you focused though. So, like, if you really got the right one, she keep you.
That's true.
Okay, I have a question about that. What's up? Because at the end of the day, because I've you know,
I'm gonna let you handle this one.
Go ahead.
So what do you expect? Because I've before in relationships, I've been like, all right, get your lazy ass. I don't really know how to say it or what to say. So like, I want you to say that.
Like, I would love for you to push me because she hates it too. But I'm push. I'm big on that, especially me being an entrepreneur. I'm like, all right, like. How can, again, going back to once you pass the honeymoon stage, what's next? Like, are we going to grow together? Are we just going to go to work, go 9 to 5?
Do you expect your woman to be an entrepreneur as well? Because
I don't. Mm-hmm. I would love that because I see the way of life. Rather than kind of being like, oh, I want to be a fitness trainer. I want to be this. I'm like, I just want to be free. I just want to be able to go do vacations, go do whatever we want to do. The shit we see on the phone, I want to be able to do that at free will, not have to show it. But actually just doing it. So I see the avenue of doing that. So it's not like I'm trying to push you to be an entrepreneur.
PPP loans.
But I'm like, hey, shit, I wish. But so, nah, I ain't looking at it like that.
Cozy shit.
Expect her to say, like, if you were slacking, or what would you expect out of your relationship from that point, from that standpoint of, like, what would you expect your woman to do? Or, like, what? Give me an example of, like, what a woman has done for you to be like, all right, now I actually need to be on my shit.
Yeah, I mean, it's more accountability. So if you see me, sitting.
I was thinking it was self shit. Like,
I mean, it's you too, and I'm a big person that works on himself literally every day. But it's like I want you to hold me accountable too. If you see me slacking 2 days in a row or something, like, all right, what's going on? Like, at least communicate with me. You know, I'm big on over communicating.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because
it's like, all right, like I don't want to just sit in my head and be like, oh, what's wrong? Like, this, what's you thinking
of?
I am
not big on over communicating. Please shut the fuck up. You know what I'm saying? If I'm deep in thought, just leave me alone.
I feel that.
Sometimes, like, I give my wife attitude, and I have to remind her, it's like, it's not you, it's me. I'm dealing with my own shit right now. You know what I'm saying? Like, I be telling people, hey, when people give you, like, attitudes and shit, stop taking that shit personal. They dealing with some internal shit.
Yeah.
I literally have to remind her, it's like, damn, why it's not you, bro. I'm just in my head thinking about some shit, like, how I'm gonna get these motherfucking M's. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like,
Like,
dead ass, I'm tired of you. You tired of doing this shit?
I just know for me, like,
you don't want to have sex or nothing like that.
I would be so much further in life if I had a woman. I ain't gonna lie to you.
It's a complete contradiction of everything you've just been saying.
No, for real. Like, for me, if I was looking for that, if that's what I wanted, like, because I'm not looking for it right now. That's why, you know, I'm not in one, obviously. But I just know that if I was in one, I know I'd probably be much further.
Why you think that?
Yeah, I'm convinced.
Yeah, me too.
Because they're expensive.
Yeah, I'm telling you.
I love her.
I feel like a hundred dinner.
I can't even go out and buy 2 pounds of crabs, bro.
No, that shit is expensive.
$98.
Nah, but I think the accountability part too. You know what I'm saying? Like sometimes you need someone to be on you, like when you slipping up, because you're not always gonna be on point.
Yeah.
Like some days you just don't like not be motivated. Some days you gonna want to take, you know, a day off or something like that. Sometimes you need that person to be like, yo, like, come on, let's go.
Yeah.
That'd be
little. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Really? Yeah, so I've recently, God, I'm just such an overshare. But I recently, my man's very well off in a sense. Like, not in the sense of like millionaire. You know what I'm saying? Not like that. But like, he's well, like, he doesn't have to like.
Chilling. He's an exceptional earner.
Yeah. So he can, his money comes to him even if he isn't working for like a day. But Yeah, so I still feel like sometimes I'm like, all right, you sleeping a lot later. And it's like, I'd be feeling like sometimes confused because I'm like, who am I to say something? Because I have to work to make money. So I'm like, who am I to say something?
I ain't even saying about that. I was going to say about you sleeping till 12.
First of all, because I work late at night.
Yeah, that is.
That's a different. But like, I'm like, who am I to say something? That's why I'm like, what am I like, in a sense, because I did actually, I tried to like, you know, address it in a sense. And he was just like, basically put me back in my place and was like,
What yeah. Kanye West say? I don't talk money don't with broke bitches.
And it wasn't even that, but it really, to me, is like, I'm slightly being like, you know, so maybe we should start a routine of like working out together, doing this. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to like enforce that type of habit. And I'm just like, because that I know from working out can attract a different level of mindset of like waking up early or doing this. You know what I'm saying? So I'm slowly trying to like gradually do. And I'm like, I didn't think it was received properly in a sense of like me being like, don't tell me what to do. And I'm like, that's not what I meant. You know what I'm saying? So I was just wondering how.
How do you say that? How did you say it?
I said it like, you cheesecake eating ass nigga, get the fuck up. What are you doing? No, but it's like, and he, not like that, but I was just like, you know, I want an accountability partner. And he was just like, first of all, that starts with yourself. He was like, don't act like I'm holding that. Starts with you, but he was, I know he's just like you, Amber. He was like, it starts with yourself. Literally like, you know, you don't say I'm holding you back, because I slipped up and I was just like, you know, I just want somebody to help me out too. And he was just like, you could do all these things. He was like, I haven't changed from the moment you met me. You know what I'm saying? So I was like, I get it. And it's like, now I just feel like, all right, maybe we, like, I just think of a mindset standpoint. Same. You know what I'm saying? So it's like,
the right person will get you right. Back. Not just any relationship, because there are certain relationships that will hold you back. Like, you have to have the right person in your corner, because there's a lot of people out here that are just leeches, basically.
So am I the wrong person?
No, you.
I mean, I don't know your relationship. So I can't answer that. But the right person will push you to, you know,
and
you're going to
respect it, and you're going to, like, respect it, you know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, he probably never seen that side of you, so it's kind of like a surprise.
Does he work out?
You know what I'm saying?
No. And that's just a...
You got...
I said no, he doesn't.
There's something about that.
No, he is a nice figure. No, not figure as in like that, but I'm saying, like, it's simply to me.
Big guy. He's not big.
He's not big at all. But
not
I'm
fat.
I know how I feel when after I work out. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a different type of mindset. It makes you want to, like, take the rest of the day on. He works at night also, though. Mm. So when he does work, it is at night. So I do get it. I do get the standpoint of it. But it's like, I don't know. I just kind of want to, like, it should start with me, so I get it. But it's like, I just want an accountability partner in that sense of, like, doing things like that. And he is very supportive and very helpful and very, like, he's, like, when I filmed a podcast and I was shit. He was the first person I called, and he was just like, it's like the gym. You got to keep working at it. He was like, don't feel bad. You know what I'm saying? So he's very supportive in my relationship. And I feel like where I'm falling apart is that I don't feel like I feel like I'm lacking. Like, I should be helping him in the same way that he supports me. And it's, wow, that's
why are you
mind
lacking?
Blown for me.
Why are you lacking,
I
though?
Just realized that.
Why you think you lack?
Shy don't know that she's the product. You know what I'm saying?
Right, why you think you lack, though? That's what I'm... So I think he's just saying it starts with yourself, because a lot of people don't do shit that you just say unless you actually just do it. Because like me personally, I mean, again, keep bringing up Cam, but she didn't go to the gym before. I'm in the gym every day.
So six. She goes to the gym.
Now she
you?
Goes to the gym now with me.
Oh, because so you it's do not, what you were doing
I do
it before.
So I'm doing me. Okay. At the end of the day, I'm always going to do me, focus on me, but then I'm bringing her with me because I want her to be a part of me. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of, yeah, I would I like it like that. That. I would. Just because, like...
But she do Pilates and shit. That man don't want to do no fucking Pilates.
I ain't gonna lie, that's
that man
fun.
Don't
want to
do no
good
fucking
workout,
Pilates.
Pilates,
yeah,
great workout.
It's hard, though, but it's fun.
Yeah. It is. Men don't realize that Pilates is a great
it's
workout.
It's the crazy ab workout.
I feel like y'all should start just... I mean, I don't know what gym you work at right now. Are you working out at a gym?
I was just giving an example. No, but I was just giving an example of, like, you know, maybe... I was, like, meditating, doing this and that, but I'm just, like, you know, I was throwing shit out there in a sense, and I didn't think it was received well, but I just realized now it's, like, I want to give him what he's giving to me in a sense of, like, you know, upping myself. Like, he helps me get better, you know? So I'm, like, well, I want you to get better. I want to do something for you, you know?
Right. Was it just that situation, or is it just in general? Like, with certain things.
And it was that situation.
And I'll say, how do you feel like he makes you better?
Support.
Support? Okay.
It's a nice support system. Once it, like, supports anything that I'd be willing to do. Like, nice. I have a wild mouth sometimes. And a lot of men
he a cool guy. I like him. Yeah. Fire. He a cool guy.
Fire. See? It's I guess if you don't have that objective, it kind of looks weird, you know what I mean, to somebody. But if you got that objective and that purpose and the vision, it's like, you just kind of got to show them. Once they see it, like, damn, you getting fit? They're like, shit, I'm cool, I'm coming too.
And, like, your solution, like, there's an easy solution for that. Like, just go on a hike.
Yeah.
Like, one Saturday, Sunday, just go on a hike, you feel me? Yeah. And then just, like, try to make that, like, a routine for, like, a month. Yep. Every Sunday, y'all just And it's quality time.
I don't know. I'm going to be honest.
Two birds with one stone.
Lil be trying to go hiking and shit, and I'm not in the mood.
Get your ass up and go hiking.
Yeah, I get annoyed. But if I'm not in the mood, I'm going to get annoyed. Like, bro, I just said I don't want to do that shit. Yeah. Like, just because you want to, you go do that. Take the dog and go do that. I'm chilling right now. I'm in my zone.
So and that would, if I was Lil, that would piss me off. That would make me bad too.
Yeah, it would.
All right, shit. But I'm out. Take my big ass dog.
It's hot as fuck out there. Like, she was trying to do this during a fucking heat wave. Like, bro, I'm not doing that. I'm not doing that. It's 8 o'clock, hot as fuck. I'm like, bro, I got annoyed for her even suggesting a hike at 8 o'clock. Like, 8 o'clock usually good. We could do that before 12. Yeah, before 12, we could do it. But it was like 100 degrees at 8 a.m.
Me and sun do not mix.
Yeah, 8 a.m. is crazy. 100 degrees.
It was hot during the heat wave. I was like, yeah.
Yeah, my dog's paws would be burnt.
Yeah, and that's why I'm like, it's too hot for her.
I'm laying down. Shit. Her big ass.
You got the most melanin.
Yeah, bro, you good.
It's still hot. Shit. It's still hot. All right, so but anyway, shit, where can we find y'all, man?
Amber DW says, that's Amber DWSAYS, not Amber D Ways. Everywhere. That's where you can find me. And the Says Podcast, THESAYS__ on Instagram. I be posting some funny shit on there.
She's hilarious. Oh, what about and my you, name is Chy Montanette. You can find me on Instagrams, chy.f.
Final thoughts of the podcast, y'all?
Now, I got one more question for him. And this is, it's not a relationship question. So what made y'all start y'all's podcast?
Oh, well, it's not our podcast.
Well, I'm saying, I know y'all have separate podcasts. So I'm curious.
I would love for you to be a host. She's funny. I started because, like, when I got out the military, it was 2014. I don't know if y'all are familiar with Taxstone, but Taxstone started a podcast. And I was like, yo, if this nigga can do it, I know I can. Because I'm like, ain't nobody going to hire me. My country has to be on their radio. So I went to the L.A. Film School and learned and got an audio engineer degree.
Fire.
Yeah, so I got an audio engineer. And I was doing working off of Pro Tools, learning how to edit my shows and shit, and then posting it. Then that's how I started. I went on my own show. Taxstone inspired me. Because I'm like, yo, if this nigga, and he was like a hood-ass nigga.
Yeah,
and
that's
and,
the one
and
to
I'm
do
like,
it.
Yo, if he could do it, I know I could do it. And that's what started it.
Shout out to Taxstone, man.
Yeah, shout out to Taxstone.
Hold your head, boy.
Yeah.
What about you, Shy? You feel like you wanted like an outlet?
I know, right? I had a lot to say, huh?
We got clips.
Delete
no cap.
It. We got all. Clips, boy. Yeah, I mean, I'm just a talkative person. Not talkative in a sense, but like, you know, just I got a lot to say. Might as well, you know, people think it's funny all the time, so might as well. Why not, you know?
She's a personality, bro.
But you're pretty.
I know I'm gorgeous, too. But she's pretty, and it's be pretty bitches that don't have no personality. Yeah, that's why I'm like, bro, you a golden star. Like, you really a clown, you know what I'm saying? It be so many pretty bitches, and they ain't got no personality. They be like, rich nigga shit. This bitch don't be on none of that type time, you know what I'm saying? Like, cool as a fan, you know what I'm saying?
And that's
she's really a blessing.
Probably because you're from the South.
I
want to see her take off.
We need more of y'all in L.A.
We do.
We don't have too much of this in L.A. Like,
because y'all not from L.A. You're from the South.
I'm from Louisiana.
That's why, exactly. But you notice so many people that aren't from L.A. are like cool. Those are always the people that kind of link up out in L.A.
I don't know.
Me personally.
L.A. will fight that. L.A. will be like,
they will fight that.
It's the migrated. It's the migrated motherfuckers that may give it a bad name, that do bad business out here.
That's very true.
Because the people that I know, that like they out in Gardena and shit, that's from here, they cooler than a fan, bro. Like Long Beach people that's out like, they cool, but the motherfuckers that
I'm
like
talking
migrated,
about the inner city ones.
Yeah, the motherfuckers that migrated.
What do they call them? Transplants.
Oh. Yeah, transplants.
Transplants.
I do not. I had a bad experience with one. I was working for 5 years with this motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Last three events, bitch wasn't feeding us. So I'm like, she sitting in the group chat. You know when they sit and run a show or a call sheet, if you got questions, you fucking ask the questions.
Right.
So I seen that she had food on her for the third time, and I'm like, yo, is food really gonna be in here? Motherfucker removed me from the group chat and messaged me 5 years with her. Removed me from the group chat and messaged me separately and was like, yeah, we doing things differently. That wasn't the place to ask that. Ask about food, bitch. Like I asked about food. You do know when people say, why you don't work with this motherfucker no more? And I tell them, because I asked about food. You look like a clown, right?
And they're not working with him.
Listen, man. These damn LA transplants.
Yeah,
She's a transplant.
They give LA people a bad rep.
They
you know what I'm saying? LA, Hollywood is not LA. Yeah. And I think people forget that sometimes because they're not from
here. That shit dirty as fuck.
So,
I stay out. It's very nasty.
These damn transplants, they come here and they're caricatures of what they see on TV and they just mess up the whole idea of LA for everybody else. So,
bro, you gotta understand though, when I was in Ohio and we seen LA, it was just like that shit was the prize land. And then when you got here, you was like, this shit nasty.
Same. When I came here at 18, I was like, oh, this is beautiful.
This is great.
I'm gonna come back. Yeah. And when I got, I was like, ew, disgusting, dirt, dust,
people
want
to live downtown. That shit, 3K to be dirty as fuck.
Exactly.
Y'all got me fucked up. It's 500. Bro, it's 500 for a two-bedroom back at the crib, man. But yeah, I appreciate you guys coming on, giving us all y'all's knowledge, dropping the gems for everybody, man. Everybody's going to tune in.
Y'all have last thoughts?
Thank y'all for having us.
Y'all have last thoughts?
This is dope. I hope y'all do great with y'all podcast. Keep going. This shit gonna be lit. You know what I'm saying? Don't be worried about that structure shit. You know what I'm saying? Just come over here and shoot the shit. They gonna fuck with it.
So before y'all go, who do y'all want to see in the podcast next? But before you answer that, you have to help us get them on the podcast. So who do you want to see?
I don't know.
I'm not signing up for that one. No, ask me.
I don't know what y'all want. Artists, music artists. I know a lot of music artists and shit, but y'all want ladies.
We want people
want?
That's going to drop gems.
She honestly did her job. She brought me. You're welcome. So.
You're right.
I did my one and done.
Now, we want people that's going to drop gems.
Does anybody, you feel me? Anybody that you feel like is interesting that will, you know, fit with the system we got here?
Because this is more of like an outlet. You know, y'all gave us gems on relationships because people can come in, tune in, and be like, oh, that's how I feel. You know, so we want some, we want somebody that's going to drop the gems and the knowledge, too.
We need some
signal
folk next time, you know.
Right?
Yeah, some
Mac
ain't ganged
up. Mac in the back, quiet.
Yeah, I'm over here, so what about this?
And also, was flipping the script, too. I needed a woman. After these relationships.
I didn't say I need a woman. I said I would be with the right person. With the right person. But I'm not looking for it, though.
I don't need these bitches. I don't know.
I'm telling you, bro, you better find you somebody and get the fuck up out these streets, boy. It's nasty out there for y'all.
I'm grinding right now, man.
It's nasty. I feel you. You're going to be grinding. Your wife, you're going to be 50. You with a wife of 21.
That's fine.
Yeah, that's
fine.
That's fine. You know, this motherfucker said women after 30, what did you say? I don't put words in your mouth.
I want to hear.
I said, listen. And listen,
they're no good. They're damaged goods after 30, basically.
I didn't say
that's
that.
That's what I heard when
this
you
is what
said
I
it.
Said. This is what I said. Society looks
we going
at,
viral today, baby.
Society no looks cap. At women who are 30 plus as their values dropping, right? This is why a lot of older men, right?
Yeah.
They go after younger girls because they don't want to have to deal with older women because they have
certain things.
Sounds like pedophilia. A younger girl can't.
My name is Hector, my boy.
But they need an older man should get an older woman who can realize when a nigga having a stroke or not. A young girl ain't gonna realize that. You know what I'm saying?
They're not worried about that.
I'm just saying.
They worried about someone who has less baggage and is younger.
And dumb as fuck. That they can control. Yeah, control. Train.
I mean, whether you want to call it control, whether it's control or however you want to say it, that's just how these men think.
What's the youngest you'll date at 27 right now?
Man, I don't know. Probably like 24. That's probably
that's
young.
He's
young
thinking
for
19
bro.
In his head.
Nah,
I can't.
It just depends, man. Honestly, like it just depends on your mindset. Really, honestly, I really don't care about your age.
Okay, Kels.
17.
Of age. You gotta be of age.
You said right
you
first
gotta
time,
be of age. 21 and over. 21 and over, please. Thank you.
Hey, nah, you said it right, bro. Yeah. Mindset, but I can't go under like 27.
You got a really good relationship, so.
But still,
can't
I mean, I
could.
I mean, just being honest,
yes,
yeah, I wouldn't. I couldn't.
How old are you?
She's 29.
29. Oh, y'all
said. Yeah,
but listen, don't take offense to that.
Experiences.
Man. That's just facts. I'm sorry. That's
and
just
post
facts.
That one and go viral. We going viral with that one. Like all the blogs gonna put. This nigga said women after 30 are damaged goods.
Oh,
do
we
y'all
gonna shade room.
Shade room. Hey,
this,
pick
this
it up.
This is why they need to stop creating
pick
all these podcasts. They gonna be on your ass.
Yeah, niggas.
Don't get us canceled first episode. Yeah, come on, bro.
Hey, I don't make the news. I just reported, yo.
Nice nigga, man.
It is what it is,
man. This was fun. Thanks for having us.
But yeah, I appreciate you guys coming on, man.
All right, you guys, and we're going to get up out of here. Thank you guys again for pulling up on us,
thanks
having this conversation. So follow them on social media. Follow us on social media.
Tap in.
Go ahead and say your Instagram handle,
Jordan Cozy.
And I'm Project Mac. And we out here.
Bottom line. I'm going to show you how to do it. Check. Yo, I spit that other shit. That's a nice motherfucker shit. Fed time following me around.